Welcome back. The French government has announced that it's going to drop a controversial bill which would have made it illegal to film police officers in action in certain situations. The bill, which sparked serious concern about the freedom of the press as well as the ability to hold the police to account in the event of misconduct, brought tens of thousands of people out onto the streets on Saturday. Well, Article 24 of the government's global security bill is instead going to be completely rewritten. Here's what the head of the ruling party, Christophe Castaner, had to say.
We are going to propose a complete rewrite of Article 24, which should reflect its dual purpose. This new text will be written within a collective framework involving the three majority groups in Parliament. It now appears evident that the legislative and semantic choices we made have prompted concern from citizens who are worried, who are in fact convinced that it would threaten the right to inform, the right to access information, as well as a legitimate system of checks and balances when it comes to police behavior. The balance that we are trying to achieve with Article 24 has not been unanimously understood. We are aware of that. Don't act.
Christophe Castaner speaking there. Well, as we speak, the French Interior Minister Gérald Darmanin is facing questions from a parliamentary commission over that new security law. Well, let's bring in our French politics editor, Marc Perelman. Marc, given what's happened these last few days, did the government have any choice but to backpedal, do you think?
The answer is no, Tom, as we just saw. This was essentially a burial for this very controversial measure that had thrown people on the streets and also prompted emergency meetings after emergency meetings, including one this midday at the presidential palace. Emmanuel Macron convened some ministers, some key parliamentary leaders, and he decided what Christophe Castaner announced, meaning the so-called rewriting, full rewriting of that controversial measure. This means that it will be dropped. It is a very awkward moment because in addition to the protests that we saw, this created a lot of havoc within the parliamentary majority because lawmakers were essentially pushed a week ago by the government to vote for that measure, and now they're being told to say that they're going to fully rewrite it. And so many are up in arms because they feel that they've been toyed with by Emmanuel Macron, who has been taken aback by the protests that he has seen and also the infighting within his own camp.
Sure, and all of this couldn't have come at a worse time, could it, for the French government, particularly the French Interior Minister, having a very tough time of it these last 5 or 6 days.
Yes, Gérald Darmanin really has attracted a lot of the criticism, and he's about to be grilled, as you just said, by a parliamentary commission. And so this is why the announcement that this controversial measure would be dropped is essentially a preemptive strike in order to facilitate his commission appearance. And so, yes, he's been criticized because we've seen instances of police violence captured on camera, which is basically what would have been criminalized if this measure had been adopted. So we've seen the beating of a black music producer that really created a lot of emotion here in France. We saw a migrant camp in the heart of Paris being essentially evacuated by the police with some quite brutal attitude by the police. And so the police brutality issue combined with the ability to document it and to hold the police to account is really front and center, and it will be front and center during this edition of the Interior Minister. He's hoping to bite the bullet, but clearly his future is on the line these days.
Okay, well, thank you very much indeed for that. Our French politics editor, Marc Perelman, and the man in question in that video, Mark Zeckler, a friend, a music producer, said, "I was lucky enough to have videos that protect me." That's the man who was seen in that video, which has now been watched 14 million times. Moving now to the United States.